If you've spent a winter in northwest Iowa, you're pretty much prepared for anything.
That's how David Thoreson describes his preparation for sailing through the Earth's polar regions. David is a photographer originally from Algona, but his family also owned a summer cabin on Lake Okoboji when he was growing up.
That's how I started sailing and developed my love for the water.
His love for photography would come several years later as a college student at the University of Nebraska at Omaha. Now he's been a professional photographer for decades and has traveled nearly 70,000 miles by boat. What started as a way to explore the world and capture its beauty quickly turned into an awakening.
I really got into the local ecology of what was going on in the polar areas and studying weather and climate patterns and seeing these changes that scientists were talking about.
Burning fossil fuels releases greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and methane into the atmosphere, which have caused it to warm at an alarming rate. The Arctic is warming 2 to 3 times faster than the rest of the world, which is causing sea ice to shrink. Sea ice reflects the sun's energy and keeps the area cool, but when the sea ice melts, it exposes the dark ocean water, which allows for more absorption of the sun's energy instead. David's adventures have allowed him to see and document some of the impacts a warming atmosphere has led to.
In 2007, I sailed through the Northwest Passage for the first time, and we were the first Americans to ever make the east to west Northwest Passage transit.
That was when sea ice in the Arctic was at its lowest. The accomplishment earned David national attention, and he was eventually asked to take part in a 400-day expedition around North and South America.
We circumnavigated the two continents, and then we would stop and we would do educational things with children along the way and with other scientists. We worked with NOAA, with NASA, with MIT, and all sorts of institutions through both hemispheres.
They also connected with local indigenous people who shared some startling messages with them. Their way of life is vanishing.
Because climate is changing so quickly that where they predicted animals to be, like in the past with the migrations, the animals are showing up at different times. The marine life, the fish, you know, certain times of the season is all upside down now so that it's unpredictable.
The unpredictability puts nearly 1 million people at risk for food insecurity. And as the permafrost also thaws, they'll lose a way to store any food they do catch.
Through these stories and spending time with scientists and actually witnessing the changes over time, I've come to a realization that we definitely are in a climate crisis right now. Things are changing quickly outside of the normal kind of long historical climate change patterns, and that we need to take some collective action.
Amber Alexander, WHO 13 News.